Harry Styles is continuing his transformation into a triple threat, singer, actor and always stylish. His latest movie is set in the 1950s and sees him play a married police officer who is secretly gay. The movie My Policeman is based on the 2012 novel of the same name and also stars Emma Corrin and David Dawson.
To all of us.
To all of us.
All of
cheers.
Us.
Cheers.
Set in the quaint seaside town of Brighton, England, My Policeman brings a star-studded ensemble to the screen. The film tells the story of Burgess, a married policeman who begins a secret relationship with museum curator Patrick. What ensues is a forbidden love triangle that spans decades.
This love is all-consuming.
I loved the fact that there were older counterparts to the younger ones. It created this feeling of ensemble and, like, shared history and shared consciousness. It was really great. I thought it would be a real challenge, and it was, to explore, like, what motivates Marion and to do what she does and to find empathy there and understanding. You know, first heartbreak that is often the most powerful and the most devastating. And you see how, you know, the decisions that she made while she was in that place, you know, affect her life and everyone's life going forward.
Take one fresh and tender kiss.
Well, David, your character is a mesmerising one. How did you approach it?
What really drew me to Patrick was the challenge of playing someone who very skillfully, out of necessity, has to have two kind of personas in order to thrive in a society in which to be his authentic self is something incredibly difficult, and how he achieves his ambitions in life by having these two very different personas.
He said you'd ask.
I wouldn't get my hopes up for Tom.
I'm not.
Tell me about your casting process. You've got these incredibly seasoned actors and then this great younger cast.
It's quite interesting when you get a call saying such and such has read your screenplay and they would love to meet. And such a call did come from Harry Styles' agent early on. And he had read this script and he had responded to it in a very positive way and had requested a meeting. Well, I have to tell you, Angela, that most of the time, directors are stuck in rooms trying to convince actors to be in their film. So it's very nice to be in a room with an actor who's trying to tell you they want to be in the film.
I think I brought Patrick here because I've been so lonely.
I was really fortunate to be able to see some of the scenes that the younger cohorts had shot because they did the 1950s stuff first. So I had four scenes that were rough cut that Emma was in.
Tom and I are married now. We have to sort these things out on our own.
When I watched anything I could find of Emma, and there's something about the way she watches and she listens, it's very beguiling and particular, and that I hooked on. I thought, that's really interesting.
Emma, we first saw you playing Diana in The Crown, and the role is about to be taken over by Elizabeth Debicki. Do you have fond memories of that adventure?
Yeah, such fond memories of that adventure. It was incredibly special. And yeah, I know Elizabeth and she's wonderful. I think she'll do such a brilliant job.
I've got you under my skin.
David, in your love scenes with Harry Styles' character, there's a dance-like quality to them. How did you approach that?
It's very interesting you say that, because Michael, the director, brought on board a wonderful choreographer that he'd worked with many times in the theatre, intimacy coordinator, and we very much all collaborated. We were all determined to make those scenes live and breathe as part of the story to further the narrative.
Do you love him?
I love you.
I thought it was such a beautiful script, and just the complexity of Tom and everything he goes through made it like a really interesting character that I wanted to have a go at.
I wanted all of the intimacy to have a slightly choreographed sense about them. I didn't want it to be set like choreography, not 5, 6, 7, 8, not that kind of choreography. More the fluidity of hands on flesh and exploration and all of that. And dance, it's almost like something where they're expressing each other because they're finding each other. And that was wonderful to be able to explore it with those three actors.
We're just two confused people, aren't we?
What do you think audiences will take away from My Policeman?
Hopefully it will make people appreciate the freedoms and rights that have been fought for, but also acknowledge how fragile those rights can be.
we're on a real like tipping point, and I think that it's important to keep these conversations going, and I really hope the film does that.
The threats to that progression in terms of, for example, when we come back to see them in 1999, we suddenly have in this country Section 28, and it took forever to get rid of it again. And so there's so many reminders that put things into perspective again, that help us understand that if we have an interest in making progression, we've got to keep our foot on the gas.
What do you think of the guinea fowl? I'm a vegetarian. God.
We've seen you and loved you in so many things over the years. The fact you say 1999 makes me think of Notting Hill.
I know, man. Somebody brought this up the other day, and, you know, I've only ever seen that film once, and that was at the premiere. No, that's it. And so somebody was talking about it, and I was thinking, I didn't even remember that's part of the story. It's been a while, right?
Fans remember that film so fondly. I imagine the reaction from them is nice.
Yeah, it is, and it's across all generations, which is really, really lovely.
Come with me,
that younger generation, which I believe to be the least prejudiced generation ever born, when they come into contact with this film because of people like Emma and Harry, it means that they will see a world that they won't know about necessarily, where the law meant you weren't free to be yourself. And I hope that they become passionate advocates for moving forward, not backwards. That will be a powerful voice to have on our side.